the channel. In today's video, we will attempt to solve the container with most water leet code problem. I will leave the link to this problem down in the description below. So, in this problem, we are given an integer array named height of length n. This array can be represented with vertical lines such that the two endpoints of the ith line are i0 and I height at I. What we need to do is find the container that contains the most water, a container being two vertical lines linked together in parallel to the x-axis. Then return the amount of water stored in that maximal container, that amount being the area of the container. The biggest container we can deduct from this example is marked in blue, as you can see, and the max amount of water stored in that container to return, which is basically the area of this container, is 49. So, if the first index of this container is I, and the second one is j, then the amount of water this container can store can be calculated with the help of the equation you see in front of you. Okay, until now all we did was understand and lay out the definition as provided to us. But the solution to this problem is basically finding the I and j variables such that the area we are calculating is maximized. So, this equation needs to be maximized, and the variables that we have are I and j. Therefore, one trivial solution to this problem is to make use of two nested loops and iterate over all possible combinations of our variable pairs. For each pair, we're going to calculate the local area with the help of the equation we just wrote, all while trying to maximize the global area, which is then returned to the user when the loops end. This works, however, its complexity is quadratic, and if you happen to be asked this question in an interview, then most probably the interviewer is looking for a linear time solution. So, how do we solve this problem in linear time? Throughout this series, we learned several approaches to tackle different problems, but one of them stands out when it comes to having two variables. You guessed it, the two pointers approach. Okay, let's bring back our example and initialize two pointers, one at the start and one at the end of the array. How will moving these two pointers strategically help us find the maximum amount of water in linear time? Well, take this first container, its area is 8. Now, this 8 is limited by the left pointer as the height at the left is smaller than the height at the right. And what we are ultimately trying to do is maximize the area. So, for the next iteration, if we increase the left pointer, we have a higher chance of hitting a bigger area than if we decrease the right pointer. Additionally, the line represented by the left pointer can be now discarded completely because we just took the maximal area it can provide. Why? You see, no matter which other right vertical line you pick, if you combine it with this left line, it will lead to a smaller area as the horizontal line will shrink no matter what, and the vertical one will be delimited by the left height. Same applies to the second iteration, in which we will have to move the right pointer. That is the maximal area that right vertical line can provide. If you take any other vertical line while attempting to move the left pointer, the area obtained will be smaller or equal to the one we calculated, as it will either be delimited by the current right vertical line, a smaller left vertical line, or a smaller horizontal line, because the index difference we just calculated is the best it can offer. Okay, to implement this solution, and as we mentioned, you will need a left and right pointer. The iteration will stop as soon as these two pointers collide, or when left is equal to right. And inside the loop, we will always attempt to maximize our current water area, similarly to what we did in the brute force approach. If the current area is limited by the left pointer, then we increment the left variable. On the other hand, if it's limited by the right pointer, then we decrement the right variable. And that's it, the linear solution for the container with most water problem. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions in the comments below. And that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.